Hello and welcome back for some more Amberstar. Played in a blind manner. We're at the tomb of the Pharaoh, the shrines, which is the second floor. We are apparently supposed to find presents from Gala, Bela, Nut, and a few others. Gek or something. Or Geb. Jeb. And a couple others. So, in these are shrines, which actually only looks like rings in the wall. I guess, you know, they didn't have the graphics capability to display the shrines like the way they wanted to, I'm guessing. And I'm guessing through this, there's six gods, and there's six of these teleporters. Never mind this one, which we should not be able to have seen. But I'm guessing that's the way back out once we finally appease all these gods. And so I'm guessing the presents are through these teleporters. We have to find them. And, yeah, return them to just get out of this place. But we're doing pretty okay so far. There's Gribben. Oh, Gribben's okay. Boing! A deep, reverberant voice says, Geb. What says Geb? Alright, so we're in Geb. Godrooms. Okay. Okay. So there is no... We're at the northernmost section. Could be separate sections, or could just be Godrooms. I'm thinking Godrooms is... We're going to uncover this map in six different stages. So I don't know anything about this god Geb. The only gods I remember the game mentioning were Gala and Bela. It's mostly in the very beginning. When you come across the shrine or tomb mausoleum of Marillion. Hate when those go out. What do you have for us, Geb? Okay. Geb likes twisty, winding corridors. Just making sure I'm not in a spinner and doing the thing over and over again. Okay, this door is there. Skeleton here. Another three skeletons. Eventually, I guess I'll start, you know, skipping past these fights. But they're kind of short as it is. It takes us, what, three rounds to get through these guys? Maybe two? You set them up, I'll knock them down. They're like a bunch of bowling pins, only arranged together in the form of a skeleton. That's the way I see it. Sateen, with the killing blow. Ow. Drobaneer, take him out. This is round three. Really? I was too lazy to redirect everyone's attacks. Now, we don't have enough inventory space or weight, encumbrance type stuff to be carrying that, so unfortunately, would be a real haul otherwise. Yeah, there's some kind of room door here. I'm just gonna go through this. Okay, it's just a dead end. Okie dokie. One way to go. Yoo-hoo! Ooh! They've added a skeleton! Oh my, we're in trouble now. Added one skeleton. That throws everything out of whack. I'll have her attack this one. She tends to miss her attacks a lot. I'm not even recording. I mean, not recording. Not timing. Been running for, yeah, six, almost 7 minutes. When we get large amounts of skeletons, that's when I'll start breaking out the fireballs or ice balls. Just to move Silk over so Drobaneer can help out. Yeah, I'll heal Graban. And Dromineer. In that order. That thing's gonna move. He's gonna kill that thing, so I'm just gonna not do much. Drobaneer is going to move so I can't heal him. Because I'll miss. Because wizards can't hit moving targets, didn't you know? By the time he gets over there, though... That's right. Is my brother trying to heal him? Why not? And then, boom. Huh. Okay. All these doors. We Always checking for secrets. When there's a dead end like that, I do that. As you probably have noticed. Hello. Another four skeletons or five now? Four. It's a team with a killing blow again. Wow. She's impressing me. The same. Okay, so the map looks like this. Wow. Quite a winding passage. Oh, I got a magic mouth. In whose name do you demand entry? I don't suppose it's filled in here. Jeb, no. If you can overcome the guards, you shall receive the gift of the God of the Earth. Oh, neat. Madness, yeah. There must be that door opened. Because we already had this way. This is a dead end. There's this door as well. Ah! Jeb likes dead ends. What guards? Mummies. Hello. Punch, punch. Yeah, quite a bit. When they line up, I'm gonna throw a fireball. Let's get those old rags burning. For now, though, I'll throw a rock. Now, these guys are a little tougher than skeletons, and there's more of them. But I don't think we'll have too much trouble with them. I think they cast disease. Oh, they're skeletons and mummies. I didn't realize it looks so similar on the battlefield. But now that they're lined up in the center screen, or, well, left screen, I can see them. Alright, so, yeah, skeleton, mummy, skeleton, mummy, skeleton. So let's team up on this guy. Throw a fireball. Ice ball might be effective, but I'm thinking fireball, because, you know, old bones and dry bandages might be more effective. Nice. Can't hurt. You on that skeleton. You on that skeleton. We'll help him. Not a fireball, actually. All these one hits, one hit point hits. Silk, you gotta move over so Drobaneer can come around and help out. I'm gonna stop throwing fireballs now. I will heal Gribben. And then Drobaneer. Oh, I don't want to move. No. Gribben resists whatever it was casting. I think it's disease. Alright, he's full. Let this guy move over. I should have went to heal Drobaneer first. He's moving now. I can't do it. Okay, he moves over. He's here now to slice you in two. And now I can heal him, because he's going to be standing still long enough for me to do so. Nice. 17, 12, awesome. 16, boom, dead. Dead again. Is he full? I think he is. Close enough. Now, Gribben can't take part, but that's okay. We'll get rid of this guy quickly enough. Yeah, he's fine with points as well. So these are your guards, huh? I'm afraid we're making short work of them. Oh! These guys. The flails. That's right. The flails fetch a lot of money for whatever reason. I don't know. So, you know what we're gonna do? We're gonna drop the chain. I wonder, too. 6 kilograms, I think that is. So we're gonna drop the chain mail. Get the flails. I think the flails are a little bit lighter. Yeah, we definitely want to be selling these. And 66 gold. Look at this thing. Doesn't this look like a trap? This looks like a trap to me. Oh, a black plate mail? Armour of Geb. Really? Good band can hold it. Now, I'd identify it, but that might be what we need to present to, like, get out of this place. Wouldn't be no fun to have, you know, special magical plate mail and be stuck in this dungeon forever. Okay. And then we have this. Bringing us somewhere. Maybe back, so we don't have to go all the way back. Yeah, there is no way out, right? Yeah. Gonna save anyway, just in case. As you step into the light, your eyes see only darkness. The red circle. Oh, maybe this is where we brought back every time? Okay. Now I gotta find out which one's Geb. I think it's one of these first ones. This way? Show me the present from Geb. How do I do that? Do I use it? I am curious, though. We'll identify it just to see if there's anything. Because she's got a few identifiers she can use. Even if we can't keep it. Okay, so it's shield 10. It gives you strength boost of 15. I hope we get to keep it. Shield 10. Oh, it's not as much as his plate mail, though. I don't know. And the plate mail is a lot heavier. I don't know. But that shield is a lot better. I'm not sure if I'd even keep it, tell you the truth. Sad to say. Because he's got plate mail as well. And they're the only classes that can wear it. So I'm not sure how I show it. We'll try using it. Okay, I still have it. What's this? Did I not map that out? I guess that one's satisfied. I want to check that in the corner though. Just in case that is something that opened up. Am I headed the right way? No, I'm not. Oh, because I can't advance past the box, that's why. Now, what I'm thinking is you have to show all the presents. Nothing's going to be revealed until you do it all, but I want to just take a peek on the other level. Can't get go that way. I want to peek back up the stairs is what I want to do. Probably gonna be a big waste of time, I know. Better them than me, I'll say. I just want to peek up top and take a look at the map. It doesn't look any different. Torches run out quickly. No! What to use? That one's Geb, right? Geb. Alright. Now headed to this one. Which is Nut. Godrooms. Okay, there's where we've been. Okay, interesting. So it's really just a huge level split up into six sections, I'm assuming. So it's not just Geb who likes dead ends. T. two doors, three. Maybe I should just start going through the doors. Oh, hello! That almost startled me. 4 skeletons, well, we've seen that before. He's using his stones a lot. He's gonna be out of them soon. Oh, didn't we give someone else some? Yeah, silk. You can't carry them. Well, she's got 5. What's with the elaborate dead ends? Start going through these doors. Oh, hi. Surprise skeletons all the time. Okay, we bashed those bones pretty good. What's that? Oh, just for a dead end. Really? This whole thing's just a dead end. Sheesh. Thank you. damage. What's the purpose of these dead end rooms? Magic Mouth of Doom. One little area we haven't been in. Actually, two. This way and that way. But we're here. In whose name do you demand entry? Somebody who's... nuts. If you can overcome the guards, you shall receive the gift of the Goddess of the Sky. Sounds pretty cool. Okay, it opens that door. Technically, you can open this without fighting these guys. Punch, punch. How rude.